In this video, I will show you the basic program in graphical language ladder for building automation on PLC. Here I have codesys and two networks in graphical language ladder, and here I have simulation software Home.io. Thanks to that, you can simulate smart home. How does it work? Single click on monosable button, light is on. Once again, single click on monosable button, light is off. Once again, light is on. So it is your final version of your code, and let's get started. Firstly, download the project template below the video. Unpack this package and you will see three files. First file is a communication map in the Connect.io software. Thanks to that, you can connect Home.io and codesys on your computer. The second file is ready to use project. If you have problems with writing the first program, you can use this project and fix the errors. In this video, you will write your first program with me from scratch. That's why open the third file, which is a template project. Now, go to the project tree and open the main program PLC PRG. There, you will find a few variables that are necessary to use in your program. Let's go to the body of your program. In ladder language, the program is divided into networks. How to add the first network? Right mouse click on the body of the program and choose Insert Network option. You can imagine a network as a one single line of code where you create a program logic. Before you start coding, let's go to Home.io and define functionalities of your program. Open Home.io software, then press on the new button and confirm the operation. You have just created a new simulation, so now go to the living room. Right now you can test your simulation only locally. That means you can't communicate with codesys. When buttons and another devices are marked in red, there is no communication with external devices. You can test the behavior of rollups. I open a balcony door. I press the button up only once, and as you can see, I turned light on by the swimming pool. Look at that. If you quickly click the up button, the state of light changes. Our task is to create a program in codesys in order to control the lighting button. How to make available variables in codesys? You need to change a color of variable. You can do it by clicking variable and color changes to blue. Okay, this is the first variable which we will use in our program, and we are going to make available another variable. Here we have light switch 2. Okay, and change this color to blue. We have just shared two input variables, but we need another output variable, which is lamp. Here we have lamp on the ceiling. Here we have smoke detector, and here we have lights. Okay, so I will share that. And now we can go to codesys project and start programming. On the right side of the project, you will find the elements from which you will create a program logic in ladder language. Open folder ladder elements. Here you will find the most popular instructions like normally open buttons, normally closed buttons, and coils. To implement our program concept, we need to use a function block called CTU, counter app. Okay, so now just hold the symbol of CTU and drag it down to the sign start here in the first network. The symbol of this counter will appear instantly, and next you need to declare the name of this block and click enter on the keyboard. Here we have auto-declare window. Here we have the name and the type of the counter. Approve this block by clicking OK. Here in this window, there is a place to declare. Now you should configure all inputs and outputs of the declared block. If rising edge of the signal appears on the CU input, the memory of the counter will be incremented by 1. However, if the rising edge of the signal appears on the reset input, the memory of the counter will be decremented by 1. The last input of this block is preset value PFAU. When this value reaches the same value as on output counter value, then Q output changes state from false to true. Click on the question marks assigned to PFAU input and insert 1 there. Click enter on keyboard. Look at the project tree. Here we have global variables. Here we have 3 variables: X button lamp 1, X button lamp 2. Let's go to the main program. Click on question marks here and choose those 3 dots. Here you have input assistant. Go to application, go to living room global variables and choose X button lamp 1. Double click and choose enter on keyboard. You have just connected boolean variable for button. Now we are going to connect our coil. So click on toolbox, go to ladder elements and choose coil. Drag and drop to the Q output. Here we are going to choose output variable, which is X lamp living room. Okay, we can delete question marks on CFAU output. We don't need that. And on reset input, we are going to put another local variable, which is X reset counter. Okay, your program is almost ready. So in summary, we have realized the basic functionality of this program. What you need to do right now is to open another file from my package. Go to the folder with files I gave to you in the beginning of the video. Here, open Connect.io file. The name of this file is map first program in LAD. Thanks to this communication map, you can easily establish communication between Home.io and CodeSys. Okay, go back to your CodeSys project. Go to the bottom right corner on your screen. Find an arrow and find your virtual PLC. Right click on PLC icon and choose Start PLC. Confirm it by clicking OK. Make sure that your PLC is working correctly. The icon should change color from gray to red. Go to the online tab in CodeSys and click on login. Then click yes and click yes once again. You have just downloaded a program to virtual PLC. Now go to the toolbox above and click on the start button. Okay, your program is in run state. We are going to test our program, so in this case, the best way to do so is to set up environments next to each other. Open Home.io, drag it to the left corner of the screen, and on the right half of the screen, choose your program. Click on a pin here to auto hide devices. In my 3D smart home simulation, move and go to the our first button. Click the up button one single time. As you can see, the input signal appears in our ladder network, and the value of the counter has been incremented by one. What's happening now? If the value in the counter memory is the same as value on PV input, then the output changes its state from false to true. In consequence, the light in the living room is now switched on. Click the up button once again. The counter value has been incremented by one, and now it's two. Okay, so click the up button a couple of times, and as you can see, the value in our counter is rising. To sum up, counter value saves the clicking number. Your task is to use the functionality of this counter. You need to reset the counter value when it reaches a particular number. Let's do a small modification in our program. Go to online tab and choose logout. Okay, I will hide the project tree. In the first ladder network, do right mouse click and choose option insert network. We have inserted another network. In another words, we inserted another line of code. Go to toolbox and drag box symbol in the first network. In the field with the black question marks, just type equal sign and click enter on keyboard. To the first input in this block, connect I counter value. This is integer variable. We can also connect this variable to the CV output on our counter. How to do that? Just type here I counter. To the next input of our equal sign, just type constant value, it is 2. Right mouse click on the output of this block and choose insert coil. You need to add a reset counter variable, so copy it, right mouse click and choose copy, click on red question marks, right mouse click and click paste. Enter. That's all. Go to online and click login. Click yes. Here we have three different options. We can download only changes or choose login with download. If you choose login with download, all values in our program will be resetted. So we are going to choose this option and click OK. Once again, start program. Our lights are off. One single click on a monostable button. Light is on. Click once again. Light is off. Once again. Light is on. Once again, light is off. My congratulations. You have written your first program for building automation on PLC. In next lesson, we are going to modify this program and we'll add next button here. So we'll create OR logic gate. Thanks for watching and see you later.